In this video, I'll be using an example to explain earned value management at project task level, and I'll be rolling it up to project level. As part of the example, we will be preparing a Gantt chart and calculate the baseline cost. Then we'll be calculating the progress up to the status line, and we'll be calculating the planned value, earned value, and your actual cost. We'll also be preparing an earned value graph. And we were calculating the schedule indicators, that is now your schedule variance percentage, and schedule performance index. And we will also be calculating the cost indicators. That's your cost variance percentage, cost performance index, your estimate at completion, the variance at completion, and our to complete performance index. You can also have a look at my other two examples, example one and example two, where the different earned value management formulas are explained and how to interpret your earned value management results. So let's have a look at the example. So in our example, we've got task A to task F. Each task has got a duration. Then we've got our baseline cost or our total cost, and the total cost is calculated from the assigned resources. So for task A, John has been assigned at a rate of $40 per hour, and the working hours per day is 8 hours per day. So it's 40 times 8, it's 320 times 2 days, so it's 640. John is also assigned to task B, again at $40 per hour. So it's 40 times 8, 320 times 4 is 1280. Now, Sam is assigned to task C at $50 per hour. So 50 times 8, it's 400. 400 times 3 is $1,200 is our cost for task C. Then John is assigned for task D. So it's 40 times 8, 320 times 2 is 640. Sam is assigned to task E. So it's 50 times 8, it's 400. Times 1, it's 400. And then John is assigned to task F. It's 40 times 8 times 2 is 640. Then we're going to determine what is the status of the project tasks and the projects after 6 days. So our status line is after 6 days. And task A is 100% complete after 6 days. Task B is 75% complete. Task C is 50% complete. Task D hasn't started yet. Task E is 50% complete, and task F haven't started yet. So now let's prepare our Gantt chart and calculate our baseline cost. So the start, that's our milestone, it's connected to task A. So the start is connected to task A. Task A is connected to B and C. B and C. Task B is connected to D. And task D is connected to F, and F is connected to our finish milestone. Then task B is connected to task E, and task E is connected to F. So that is our Gantt chart with our critical path. It's A, B, D, and F. So that's in red is our critical path. And the tasks in blue is tasks that has float. So let's calculate our baseline cost. So as we've calculated in the previous slide, task A has a cost of $640. And that is evenly distributed over the 2 days. So it's 320 and 320. Task B is $1,280, evenly distributed over the 4 day duration. So 320, 320, 320, and 320. Then task C has got a cost of $1,200, evenly distributed over 3 days. It's 400, 400, and 400. Task D, 640 over 2 days. It's 320 and 320. Task E is $400 over 1 day. So it's 400. And then lastly, task F is 640 over 2 days. So it's 320, 320. So now let's look at our cost per day. Day 1 is 320, day 2 320, Day 3 is 320 plus 400, it's 720. Day 4, 720. Day 5, 720. Day 6, 320 plus 400, 720. Day 7, 320. 8, 320. 9, 320. And 10, 320. So the duration of our project is 10 days. And then the cumulative baseline cost is 320 plus 320 plus 720, and finally it's $4,800, and that is our budget at completion. So let's just have a look at our chart, our cumulative baseline cost or planned value for the project. That is blue line. That's our cumulative cost with our budget at completion for the project at $4,800. So now let's look at our progress at our status line. So the status line is after day 6. This is our status line. And we will be looking at what happens up until the status line. So let's start off with our planned value. That's our budgeted cost of work scheduled. So that is what was planned up until the status line. So we've got 320 plus 320 for task A, so that's 640. 320 plus 320 plus 320 plus 320 up until our status line is 1280. Task C, 400 plus 400 plus 400, 1200. Task D hasn't started yet. Task E is 400. And task F haven't started yet, so that's zero. So if we look at our days, day 1 is 320, 2, 320, 3, 720, 4, 720, 5, 720, and day 6, 720. And cumulative, our planned value up until our status line is $3,520. Now secondly, let's have a look at our earned value. Now earned value is a percentage complete times the baseline cost. So for task A, 100% times 640, that's 640. Task B, 75%, so task B is 75% completed. So out of the 4 days, this green represents our progress at 75. So 75 times 1,280 is 960. Task C is 50% complete. So it's 50% complete. That green line represents the 50%. So it's 50 times 1,200, 600. D hasn't started yet. Task E is also 50% complete. So 50 times 400 is 200. And cumulatively adds up to $2,400. So that's our earned value up until our status date. Now let's have a look at our actual cost. Now remember, our actual cost or actual cost of work performed is all the cost associated with the task up to the status line. That can be direct cost or indirect cost. We just need to make sure that that represents all the costs that incurred on a project. So for this project, task A, the total cost was $750. That was all the cost that was incurred. Task B is $1,000, task C is $500, nothing on task D, task E was $350. So the actual cost for the project is $750 plus $1,000 plus $500 plus $350, that's $2,600. So now let's just have a look at what was the actual cost after day one. That was previously calculated to be $350. Add after day 2, it was 400. So that's 350 plus 400 gives us 750. At the end of day 3, it was 320. Day 4, 340. And day 5, 340. That added up to 1,000. And then for task C, it was 350 and 150, adding up to 500. And then for task E, it was 350. A day 6. So let's just look at our different days. Day 1, it was 350. Day 2, the actual cost is 400. Day 3, it's 320 plus 350. It's 670. Day 4, 340 plus 150. It's 490. And day 5, it's 340. And day 6, it was 350. Cumulatively, that added up to $2,600. So our planned value for the project is $3,520. Our earned value for the project is $2,400. And our actual cost for the project is $2,600. So let's have a look at our earned value management graph based on the information that was calculated. So our blue line represents our planned value for the project. Then we've got our status line after day 6. And we've calculated our planned value to be 3,520. Our actual cost to be 2,600. And our earned value, 2,400. And then as part of our calculations in our next slides, our cost variance, that is our earned value minus actual cost. From this, you can see that our actual cost is more than the work that has been performed. So we over cost here. And then our earned value is also much less than the planned value, meaning the project is behind schedule. It is our scheduled variance. So let's have a look at our schedule indicators, starting off with task B. So we're going to do the calculations for task B, and it's similar then for the other tasks, as well as for the project. So our scheduled variance is earned value minus planned value. If the value is positive, it's ahead of schedule. If it's negative, it's behind schedule. And if it's zero, it's on schedule. Right, so the scheduled variance for task B is our earned value. So it's 960 minus the planned value, 1,280. It's minus $320, meaning that the project is behind schedule. If we now calculate our scheduled variance percentage, that is our scheduled variance divided by planned value. So it's minus 320 divided by 1,280. It's minus 25%. So the project, the task B is 25% behind schedule. And then lastly, our scheduled performance index is earned value divided by planned value. So it's earned value divided by planned value. And that is 0.75. It's less than 1. The task B is behind schedule. The same can then be done to calculate that for task A to F, as well as for the project. So if we just quickly look at the project, again, our scheduled variance is earned value minus planned value. So it's minus 1,120. Scheduled variance percentage is scheduled variance is minus 1,120 divided by our planned value, 3,520. It's minus 31.8%, meaning that the project is 32% behind schedule. Now lastly, let's have a look at our cost indicators. Again, starting off with task B. And firstly, calculating our cost variance. Now our cost variance is earned value minus actual cost. And if it's positive, we underplanned cost. If it's negative, we overplanned cost. And if it's zero, we on our planned cost. So let's look at task B. Earned value is 960 divided by 1,000, so it's minus 40. So it's negative, so it's overplanned cost, task B. Now if we calculate our cost variance percentage, that's our cost variance divided by earned value. So our cost variance is minus 40 divided by our earned value, so it's minus 4.2%. So we minus 4.2% over our cost for task B at our status line. Our cost performance index is earned value divided by actual cost. If it's greater than 1, it's underplanned cost. If it's less than 1, it's overplanned cost. And if it's 1, it's unplanned cost. So it's earned value 960 divided by actual cost 1000, it's 0.96, meaning that it's less than 1, so it's over planned cost. Then our estimate at completion, there's three different formulas that can be used for our estimate at completion. For this example, we're going to be using the first one. That's our budget at completion divided by CPI. This means that the CPI is going to be the same for the remainder of the project. So we're going to calculate that for task B. So it's budget at completion, 1,280 divided by our CPI, 0.96. And that is 1,333.33. And then we can calculate our variance at completion, that is our budget at completion, 1,280 minus 1,333.33, and that is minus 53.33 that we over our budget at completion. And then lastly, we can calculate our to complete performance index. That is our efficiency to complete our project. That's our budget at completion minus end value divided by budget at completion minus actual cost. And for task B, that's 1,280 minus our end value of 960 divided by budget at completion, 1,280 minus actual cost of 1,000. And that is 1.14, meaning that we need to work harder on task B to get it completed. And then you can also calculate your estimate at completion. That's our second one, where the future work is at the planned rate. Or you can calculate your estimate at completion with both the CPI and SPI influence remaining work. And with that, you can then recalculate your variance at completion as well as your to complete performance index. The same can also be done to calculate your cost indicators for your other tasks, as well as for the project. So let's just look at the project level. Our cost variance is earned value. Our earned value, 2,400 minus actual cost, 2,600, so it's minus 200. Cost variance percentage is cost variance divided by earned value, so it's minus 8.3%. So the project is minus 8.3% over the planned cost. And we can also calculate our estimate at completion, that is 5,200. So our variance at completion currently, after 6 days, it's over expenditure of $400, and it's slightly harder to complete the project. So 1.09 is our to complete performance index. I hope this video gave you a better understanding of earned value management applying to tasks as well as to project level. And if you like this video, give me a thumbs up, or you can subscribe to my channel for more project management related videos.